Earth's twin, Kepler 452b. NASA's Kepler spacecraft has been on a wild journey since its launch in 2009, discovering over 1,000 exoplanets with thousands more waiting in the wings. These planets range from denser than iron to lighter than styrofoam, and they come in all sizes, smaller than Mercury or larger than Jupiter. Some orbit one sun, some two, and a few even dance around four. But amidst this cosmic carnival, there's a quest for something special. An Earth twin, a planet that could be our cosmic mirror, a beacon that whispers, we are not alone. Well, hold on to your seats, because Kepler hit the jackpot when it found Earth's analogue, Kepler 452b. Earth analogues. So what exactly is an Earth analogue? Imagine a planet that's not just similar in size to ours, but also orbits its star at just the right distance to potentially support liquid water, a key ingredient for life as we know it. Scientists are absolutely buzzing about finding one because, well, it could mean we're not alone in this vast universe. It's the ultimate cosmic jackpot. But here's the kicker. Spotting these Earth twins isn't like finding a needle in a haystack. It's like finding a specific needle in a stack of needles. These planets are tiny compared to their stars, making them incredibly hard to spot from light years away. Plus, their orbits might not line up just right for us to catch them in our telescopes. It's a cosmic game of hide and seek that scientists are playing, and every discovery gets us closer to answering that age-old question, are we alone in the universe? The good news is that over the years, NASA seems to have spotted some potential Earth analogues. Perhaps the most intriguing one is Kepler 452b. Discovery and characteristics. It made headlines in July 2015 when scientists announced its discovery. After meticulously analyzing Kepler data, they identified an exoplanet slightly more than 1.5 times larger than Earth, circling a G2-type star akin to our Sun. What's more, Kepler 452b resides in the Goldilocks zone of its star system. Being in the Goldilocks zone, also known as the habitable zone, means a planet enjoys temperatures that allow for the existence of liquid water on its surface. This is crucial because liquid water is essential for life as we know it, making planets within this zone prime candidates in the search for extraterrestrial life. Additionally, these planets are likely to have stable climates and conditions that support atmospheric stability over long periods, further enhancing their potential habitability. Scientifically, the discovery of such planets ignites significant interest in exploration efforts, advancing our understanding of planetary formation and the diversity of potential habitats in the universe. When exploring new planets, scientists also consider their age. For instance, a lot has happened on Earth in just a few million years, including significant evolutionary changes and events like the extinction of dinosaurs 66 million years ago. When researchers investigated the age of Kepler 452b, they found it could be akin to Earth's older, larger cousin. This is because Kepler 452b has spent a substantial 6 billion years in its star's habitable zone, much longer than Earth. This extended duration provides ample opportunity for life to potentially emerge, given the right ingredients and conditions on the planet. Reaching Kepler 452b. Earth's twin, Kepler 452b, is located approximately 1,800 light-years, or 550 parsecs away from Earth. To put this vast distance into perspective, even the fastest current spacecraft, such as the New Horizons probe that flew by Pluto in July of 2015, travels at a speed of about 35,187 miles per hour, or 56,628 kilometers per hour. If traveling directly towards Kepler 452b at this speed, it would take a spacecraft roughly 26 million years to reach its destination. This highlights the immense distances involved in interstellar travel and the challenges of exploring exoplanets beyond our solar system with current technology. Other potential Earth analogues. As I already mentioned, Kepler 452b isn't the first exoplanet found in a habitable zone. Several planets have actually been identified within the habitable zones of their respective stars, offering intriguing possibilities for the existence of liquid water and potentially life. According to NASA, about a dozen such worlds in the same size range have been discovered so far, That is, 10 to 15 planets between 1.5 and twice the diameter of Earth, depending on how the habitable zone is defined, and allowing for uncertainties in measured planetary sizes. One notable example is Kepler-186f, discovered in 2014. It orbits a red dwarf star about 500 light-years away and is only slightly larger than Earth. As one of the more promising candidates for habitability, it was the first planet with a radius similar to Earth's to be discovered in the habitable zone of another star. However, key components still need to be found to determine its habitability for life, including an atmosphere and its composition, and if liquid water can exist on its surface. Another is Proxima Centauri b, found in 2016 and located just over 4 light-years away in the Alpha Centauri star system. It orbits Proxima Centauri, a red dwarf star, and is roughly Earth-sized. Although it orbits close to its star, potentially subjecting it to solar flares and radiation, its presence in the habitable zone makes it a tantalizing target for further study. Revolution period. Living on Kepler-452b would be easy for us, as it would be very similar to living on Earth. For example, 1 year on this planet would be slightly longer than Earth's, as it takes this planet 385 days to revolve around its host star. This planet is only 5% farther from its parent star than Earth is from the Sun. This extra distance is mitigated by extra sunlight. Kepler-452b's parent star is 20% brighter and has a diameter 10% larger than the Sun. The similarities are remarkable indeed. How did scientists retrieve this crucial piece of information, though? It's all about observing the star's brightness evolution. Kepler detects exoplanets by monitoring the slight dimming of a star's light as a planet passes in front of it, known as the transit method. To determine the revolution period of Kepler-452b, astronomers analyze the periodic dimming events observed in the star's light. Each time the planet completes an orbit around its star, it transits in front of the star, causing a detectable decrease in brightness. By carefully studying the timing and frequency of these transits over an extended period, scientists can calculate the orbital period of the planet, the time it takes for Kepler-452b to complete one full orbit around its star. On NASA's website, you can find this artistic animation depicting one possible appearance of the planet Kepler-452b. As you can see, it is depicted as a rocky planet. This is because while its mass and composition are not yet determined, previous research suggests that planets the size of Kepler-452b have a better than even chance of being rocky. Where's Earth 2.0? So here's the big question. How close are we to finding Earth's twin? Finding a planet that's just like Earth, similar in size, composition, and potentially habitable, is tough work in astronomy. Even though we've discovered lots of exoplanets, spotting one that matches Earth is tricky for a few reasons. First off, our telescopes and detection methods are best at finding big planets or ones really close to their stars. Earth-sized planets in the habitable zone are small and give off faint signals, making them hard to spot. Next, we're banking on technology. New telescopes like the James Webb Space Telescope, JWST, and improvements in ground-based observatories should help us find smaller Earth-like planets and figure out what's in their atmospheres. Plus, deciding if a planet could be habitable means studying its air, makeup, and surface. Techniques like spectroscopy and direct imaging are vital, but tough to use on far-off exoplanets. Despite all these challenges, ongoing research and new tech gives us hope. We might just discover an Earth 2.0 before long. Every new find helps us learn more about planets and brings us closer to finding one that might have life beyond our own solar system. Kepler-452b and SETI. It should be pointed out that following the discovery of Kepler-452b in July of 2015, the Search for Extraterrestrial Intelligence SETI project promptly aimed its antennas towards this Earth-like exoplanet. Scientists involved in SETI employ radio telescopes and advanced equipment to scan for signals from distant stars and planets, with Kepler-452b being a particular focus. The goal is to detect signals that could indicate technological or even biological activities on planets beyond our solar system, potentially revealing the existence of extraterrestrial intelligence. However, no signal has been detected coming from it so far. I already told you how Kepler 452b is slightly larger than Earth and likely possesses a rocky composition akin to our home planet. Scientists hypothesize that its atmosphere, if present, plays a crucial role in regulating surface conditions and climate stability. Atmosphere. Detecting the atmosphere of Kepler 452b requires advanced observational techniques. Scientists study the starlight passing through the planet's atmosphere during transits to deduce its composition. Spectroscopic analysis is pivotal in identifying gases like oxygen, carbon dioxide, methane, and water vapor, crucial indicators of potential habitability. The James Webb Space Telescope, JWST, holds promise in addressing these questions and more. Already, this powerful telescope has successfully detected various molecules on other exoplanets. For instance, it identified methane, carbon dioxide, and possibly dimethyl sulfide, DMS, on exoplanet K218b. On Earth, DMS is associated with biological activity, making its detection particularly intriguing in the search for life beyond our solar system. If you want to learn more about K218b and James Webb's discovery, you can watch our previous video. Future projects. Looking ahead, the future of exploring planets like Kepler 452b and other Earth analogues is promising with advancements in space telescopes, missions, and theoretical concepts. Proposals like Luvoir and Habex, both under consideration by NASA, aim to further expand our capabilities. Luvoir was planning to use large telescopes for studying exoplanets in greater detail, while Habex focused on directly imaging Earth-like planets and analyzing their atmospheres for signs of habitability in life. However, in 2021, the National Academy of Sciences released its final recommendations in the Decadal Survey, where it suggested that NASA consider a new 20-foot or 6-meter aperture telescope, combining design elements of Luvoir and Habex. The new telescope would be called the Habitable Worlds Observatory, HWO. A preliminary launch date has been set for 2040, and the budget has been estimated to be a staggering $11 billion. Would you like to see this amazing telescope in action? Other projects, like the Breakthrough Starshot initiative, offer a visionary approach by proposing light-driven spacecraft for interstellar exploration, potentially reaching nearby exoplanetary systems within decades. Technological advancements, including improved instrumentation and data analysis techniques, will continue to play a crucial role. These developments aim to refine our ability to detect biosignatures, markers of potential biological activity on distant exoplanets, advancing our understanding of the universe and the search for life beyond Earth. Who knows what the future holds? In the meantime, let's enjoy what we have and, as always, keep it curious.